Hi. My name is Jennifer Acorn, and I am the Electronic Research Administration System Manager here at CSUMB. And some of you may also know me as the Human Subjects Research Officer. I wear two hats, but today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the reports tool in Qawwali Research. So if you'll give me just a minute here, I will share my screen and we can get started. I've logged in here as a developer. I'm delegating myself or emulating somebody. This person is Denise Weinglass. She's a typical analyst user or a type of analyst user. And so I thought she would be a good example to use. I'm in the staging environment. This particular environment is a clone from the production environment each night. So the data is only a day old today, but it may be older by the time that you see this video. Most of you, when you log into Qawwali, will see all of your left-hand navigation. If you don't, it's because you've collapsed your menu, and this is what it looks like. You can either open it up, or you can leave it collapsed and look at this little icon right here. That's the reporting tool. And I'll open it up one more time so you can say reports. When reports opens up, you'll typically have a dashboard that will look like this. You may have added already some reports to your dashboard, but if you haven't, this is what it'll look like. This is what it looks like for Denise. And so then you're gonna go over here to the research icon. You'll open that up. You're gonna go to SP. You're gonna go to classic and data. When you open up all of these, you'll see that as I close them, fewer results. Let's see, I'll go to classic. You'll see you have 11 here. And then when you open up classic and you click on data, you'll have 21. The reason I'm driving you towards data is this is really where the meat and potatoes are of reporting data and tools or the reporting tool data. You can look at some other reports. They'll give you some pretty pictures. But really what you're going to be looking for is going to be down here in a report, which you can either search for by name, or I like to go, I'm going to do awards and general. Here we go. I have two different awards, general lists is what I want. I'm not going to look at subwords right now. I'm just going to look at generals list. When you click on that, it will open up and it will show you, move my screen here. It'll show you a list of these. One of the things, there are some tricky points with the Qawwali instance of Sisense. That's what the back-end tool is that's running our reports. The first one is the data, opening up data and getting all the way down through all of those different options. That's the first. It's a little tricky to make sure that you actually open up data. The next one is going to be using the different types of filters and filtering for what you need. And then the last one is going to be this little section right here. You'll see when I mouse over this, a different set of tools opens up. Okay. This set of three dots doesn't give you what you need. It's just, if you open it up, it'll ask you like, what do you want to download, a PDF or an image? No, I want most people are going to want a CSV file. And the only way you can get that is mousing over right here and downloading it there. It's really not an easy thing to find. I've complained about it, but the reality is that it's a feature, not a bug. And Sisense isn't going to change that anytime soon. So unfortunately, we just have to learn to look for the box with the three dots instead of one up above it. The other thing I'd like to call your attention to is currently the instance is pushing data and it's covering up the small little numbers down here that show all of the pages. And that is going to change soon, but I wanted you to know at this time, it is still showing up as, you know, just covering it up. You can barely see that my hand will link to, you know, a number there, but it's hard to read. And I take it back. It's not the last thing. Another trick to Sisense and Qali is that if you want to move your data to the right, you have to mouse over to the extent that you can see this gray bar come up. See how it's disappearing? But if I go over the screen here, it'll show up, and then I have to gently move it down so that I can click on it and then drag it over. And that's how I can get to the date at the end, particularly the obligations and the project end dates and beginning dates and all of that. I'm going to drag it back. Here you can see those numbers that are being covered up by the scroll bar right now. So I apologize for that, but that is a problem that is being fixed in the system. The next thing I want to talk to you about is the filters themselves. One of the things that you may notice when you're looking through all the various tabs or maybe rows of data is that you'll notice that we do have some in there that are voided records. For some reasons, we have to leave the records in there because if they've already set up and they're stamped into Qali, the only way that we can eliminate them isn't we can't delete the record, but we can void it. And so one of the first ways that I recommend everybody do is under something called, I believe it is down here, award status. If you look under award status and scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see that void is in there. I recommend that you take that out. That should refresh everything in here because we do have a procedure that all of our sponsor programs officers follow when they need to void out a record, and that is one of the fields that they enter void into. So if you remove it from the results, then you won't see it anymore. So now you've got all award statuses except void, right? And if you'd like, you can also remove programmatically closed, since that is technically an award that's already been closed, but you don't have to because what you're going to do next is you're going to come back up here to the award notice date section. Typically, you're bookmarking or framing the data by certain dates, and this is one of the best ways to do it. There are some other dates that are down below here, project end date, project start date. If it makes more sense to use those for your framing dates, that's fine. The process is the same, so I'm going to show you how to do it here. Typically, we are looking for data that is for the past, usually the past 2 or 3 years, but starting on a specific date. So in this case, I'm going to open it up here, and rather than saying last 2 years, I'm going to go to calendar, and then I'm going to look up quarter two because this is a calendar dating system, not academic or fiscal dating system. So I'm going to go to quarter two of 2020. That gives me, there we go. That starts me in April, May, June. I'm going to toggle one more month forward because I want to start it at the very beginning of quarter three. I'm going to use this date. I'll click on it, and now it's already populated that. And now it's asking me what I want to put in here. And I'm going to click today because I want everything from the beginning of academic year, or what we would call fiscal year 2021. I've just selected that now. One of the issues that I find with this, that again, I'm working with the vendor to come up with a solution for, but because it's Sisense that's pushing this data to, or it's the background application that's running the reporting tool, they don't have as much control over how things display. But one of the things that I would really like to see here is a total number. The only way that I can get that data is now to download it. So remember what I told you in the beginning, this is not the download you want to use. You want to mouse over this area here and find the one that's in the box. Now I'm going to download the CSV file, and that CSV file can be opened up in Excel or it can be opened up in I'm going to name it sandbox data and save it. And that's where you go and you'll sort and sift from that point forward. If you have any questions about using the reporting tool, as you may have noticed, I'm going to back out here. Data, Classic, SP Research. On the dashboard page for the reporting tool, sometimes in the system it needs to refresh, so you can back out by going to your own Qali dashboard and then refreshing the reports tab or navigation. It'll reopen to your dashboard. Here you'll notice that there's two different places where you can get guidance on using the reports tool. The first is the Qali documentation. Excellent. It doesn't have any videos like this one, but really good documentation. And then this is the general tutorials from SciSense. I suggest that if you have questions and you want to self-service in terms of help, go to the Qali documentation first. And then you can always reach out to me. I schedule training as quickly as I can. As I said in the beginning of this video, I have two hats, so I can only serve as much as I can with respect to training in person, but I'm happy to do it if you're still struggling with something about this or you're not able to log in or something like that. So if you have any questions, you can reach out to us at spo@csumb.edu, or you can contact me directly at 831-582-5130. Thanks so much. Take care.